Hello everyone, let's enjoy learning. We have already uploaded part 1 of the topic pharmacokinetics. So in continuation with part 1, today we are uploading part 2 in which we will be discussing in detail the drug distribution. In part 1, we have already discussed about drug transport and drug absorption. Watch it before you proceed with this lecture. So coming to today's topic, that is drug distribution. Now once the drug enters into the bloodstream, it is distributed from plasma to the tissues. Now this distribution of the drug from plasma to the tissues is in accordance with the concentration gradient of the drug. The plasma contain high amount of drug. From this high concentration area, the drug is distributed to the low concentration tissues. Now, this transfer or distribution of the drug occurs until an equilibrium is obtained between the plasma and the tissues. Now, let us study what are the factors which affect the volume of drug distribution. First, the lipid solubility of the drug. The more the lipid solubility of the drug, the more is the volume of drug distribution. Then, ionization of the drug. Then, the plasma protein binding. If the drug is highly present in a bound form, then the distribution is less. Affinity of the tissues. If the affinity of the drug to the tissues is more, there is faster distribution of the drug from the plasma to the tissues. Also, the drug distribution depends upon the fat to lean body mass ratio and certain diseases like CHF, uremia and cirrhosis also affects the drug distribution. Now, let us understand few important concepts of drug distribution. First, what is redistribution? Now, highly lipid soluble drug, when they enter the body, they are first distributed with two organs having high blood flow. Now, these organs are the brain, heart and the kidney. From these highly perfused organs, the drug then enters into the less vascular tissues of the body such as the muscles and the fat. Now, this transfer of the drugs from these brain, heart and kidney to the tissues of lower vascularity is called as redistribution. Now, the more the drug is lipid soluble, the faster is the redistribution. Now, the problem is that if the drug has to do its primary action on brain, heart or kidney, then due to this redistribution, there is termination of action of the drug. Because it no longer remains in brain, heart or kidney, but it is redistributed to the muscles and the fats. Example of this redistribution is the oral diazepam, which because of redistribution shows a short hypnotic action of only 6 to 8 hours. Now the next important concept of the distribution of drug is the penetration into the brain and CSF. Now, there is a vast difference in the capillaries of brain from the capillaries in other areas of the body. The capillaries in the other areas in general, they have intercellular junctions and they are highly permeable, while the brain capillaries have very tight intercellular junction and they lack the intercellular space. Also, there is an investment of neural tissue surrounding these capillaries. Now, this tight intercellular junctions, lack of intercellular space, and this neural capsule around the capillary forms the blood-brain barrier. Similar type of this barrier is also found in the choroid plexus. Now, this blood-brain barrier is lipoidal in nature, so only highly lipid-soluble drugs can pass through the blood-brain barrier. Next important concept in drug distribution is passage across the placenta. Now, the placental membranes are highly lipoidal in nature and they allow free passage of the lipoidal drugs. Now, placenta also acts as a site of drug metabolism. Non-lipid drugs, if present in high concentration for longer period of time, may also gain access to the fetus. So, placenta acts as an incomplete barrier. So, any drug taken by the mother during pregnancy can affect the newborn. The next important factor is the plasma protein binding. Now, most of the drugs have physicochemical affinity to these plasma proteins. Acidic drugs have affinity to albumin, while the basic drugs have affinity to alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. Now, the binding of albumin is important. The extent of binding differs. Diazepam shows 99% binding to the plasma proteins, while flurazepam show only 10% binding. Now, what is the importance of this plasma protein binding? First, if there is more plasma protein binding of the drug, then there is decrease in the distribution of the drug. Secondly, the plasma protein binding acts as a temporary storage of drugs. So, because of this storage, the drug is not available for action. And when the free drug reduces, the bound form of drug is released. Thirdly, more the plasma protein binding, prolonged is the duration of action of the drug. Then, the plasma concentration, the plasma concentration is made up of the concentration of both the free drug as well as bounded drug in the body. Now, the degree of the protein binding should be taken into account while relating these to the concentration of the drug that is active. So, some of the drugs are highly bound to plasma proteins. Examples are, those bound to albumin are barbiturates, benzodiazepine, NSAIDs, penicillin, sulfonamides and tetracycline. While the alpha 1 acid glycoprotein binding drugs are beta blocker, bupivacaine, lignocaine, verapamil and prazosin. Now, there is also another important factor, that is displacement interaction. What is this? Let us study. Now, suppose this is an albumin molecule and this is the site of binding of the drug to the albumin molecule. These are multiple sites. So, here in this example, you can see that the drug has binded with multiple sites of the albumin molecule. While in this second illustration, you can see that this albumin molecule has this binding site and two types of drugs have come and bound to this same binding site. So, we can say that one drug can bind to many sites of the albumin molecule, while more than one drug can even bind to this single site. Now, this binding of the drug to a single site results in a displacement interaction. Now, what is this displacement interaction? It is of two types. First type occurs when one drug is highly bound while the other is weakly bound, And second type occurs when the two, both the drugs are highly bound drugs to the albumin. So what happens is that when both the drugs are highly bound to each other, they do not displace each other. But the problem occurs when one drug is highly bound while the other is weakly bound. Now this highly bound drug, it displaces this weakly bound drug. Example of this is aspirin, which is highly bound. It displaces sulfonylureas, and aspirin also displaces methotrexate. While both probenecid and indomethacin, both these drugs are highly bound, so no displacement occurs in this case. Now, sixth important factor influencing drug distribution is hypoalbuminemia. If the patient is suffering from decreased level of albumin in the blood, then there is decreased binding of the drug to the plasma protein albumin. So, more amount of free drug is available in these patients. Also, diseases such as uremia decreases the binding of the phenytoin to the plasma proteins. Now, another important factor in drug distribution is the tissue storage. Now, the drug is stored in specific organs or tissues, and this storage increases the duration of action of the drug. But the problem is that this tissue storage may also cause local toxicity. For example, tetracycline drug causes toxicity to the teeth, while chloroquine causes toxicity to the retina. Now, in bones and teeth, the drugs which are stored are tetracycline, certain heavy metals and biphosphonates. Drugs which are stored in liver include chloroquine, digoxin and tetracycline. In kidney, the drugs stored are digoxin and chloroquine. In brain, isoniazid, acetazolamide and chlorpromazine is stored. While thyroid stores iodine. And in retina, chloroquine can be stored. Iris stores ephedrine and atropine. So here we complete with the part 2 of pharmacokinetics. We have studied drug distribution in detail. The next lecture will be part 3 of the same topic, pharmacokinetics, in which we will be studying a very important topic for short answer question, that is the biotransformation of drugs or the metabolism of drugs. So if you don't want to miss any of our updated videos and you want to receive all the notifications of the uploaded lectures in sequence, please subscribe to our channel and please do not forget to hit on this bell icon so that whenever we upload a new lecture, you get a notification of it. That's all for now. Happy studying.